Hello and welcome to the episode 87 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today's highlights include wax figures, a last performance in an old TV show, and a collage of animal sounds. Let's begin with another two engagements at the Cavern Club. On the 28th of March 1962, the Beatles, featuring Pete Best on drums, performed a lunchtime and an evening concert in the Matthew Street cellar. In 1963, the Beatles Montez Row package tour graced the stage of the ABC cinema in Exeter. This was the 18th stop of the tour. In 1964, the Beatles were immortalized as wax statues by Madame Tussaud's, the famous London Museum. They were the first band ever to receive the honor. The museum lent the figures to Peter Blake and Jan Howard in early 1967 for their shot of the Sgt. Pepper's album cover. The statues were reworked a number of times during the 1960s to try to keep up with the changing image of the band. When three of the heads, assumed lost for almost 20 years, were rediscovered in 2005, they were sold in an auction for £81,500, about £112,500 in 2020 money. 1 year later, on the 28th of March 1965, the Beatles were at the Alpha Television Studios in Birmingham to record their final appearance on ABC Television's Thank Your Lucky Stars. As you might recall from episode 13 of What a Fab Day, this show had been instrumental in launching the band on a national level, but 2 years later, the format was showing its age and the show was now in steady decline. In front of a live audience, the Beatles mimed the performance of three songs: 8 Days a Week, Yes It Is, and Ticket to Ride. The appearance was rounded up by an interview with host Brian Matthew, and the whole affair went on air on the 3rd of April, between 5.50 and 6.35 p.m. In 1966, George Harrison and Ringo Starr met Roy Orbison before his concert at the Granada Cinema in Walthamstow, London. It was not a first meeting, though. As we will see in later episodes, the Beatles had toured with Orbison in May 1963, and they got to know him well back then. Finally, in 1967, the Beatles worked on the completion of two John Lennon songs at the EMI Studios in Abbey Road. First, starting at 7 p.m, John re-recorded the lead vocal track on Good Morning, Good Morning, erasing his previous attempt consigned to tape on the 16th of February 1967. He also harmonized his line before a reduction mix freed some space for further overdubs, a guitar solo by Paul McCartney, and backing vocals by John and Paul. After that, John explained an idea he had for the end of the song, a sequence of animal sound effects put in order so that each subsequent animal could have eaten or scared away the previous one. George Martin and Jeff Emerick delved into the Abbey Road archives once again, coming up with two tapes: Volume 35, Animals and Bees, and Volume 57, Fox Hunt, which gave enough sound effects to create the collage that John had in mind. Before the end of the session, the band returned its attention to Being for the Benefit of Mr. Kite, with George Harrison, Ringo Starr, and assistants Mal Evans and Neil Aspinall playing harmonica overdubs, John playing an organ overdub on the first part of the song, and George Martin playing a mellotron. For the 3-4 part in the middle of the song, the tape was run at half speed and more overdubs were added. A guitar part by Paul, more organ by John and George Martin, and a tambourine. Naturally, when played back at normal speed, the addition to the middle section would sound twice as fast and an octave higher. The session was then wrapped up at 4:45 a.m. And we can wrap up this episode of What a Fab Day too. Let me remind you to visit www.simonmas.com/support if you want to help me out improving both the number of music-related contents I can put out for free and their quality. Be fab and make the difference. In addition, as usual, the episode description has a link to the bibliography of the podcast, filled with Amazon affiliate links that you can use to support me at no extra cost when you do your Beatles-related shopping. Tomorrow, we will focus on another Pepper recording session. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.